These six web apps generate anywhere from a few thousand dollars to a few million per month for their founders using the micro SaaS business model. The coolest part is that these founders built these businesses using no-code tools, without technical skills, without hiring expensive developers, and almost with zero budgets. Some started their businesses after losing their job, while others began when they hit rock bottom. What's truly inspiring is that all of them are solo founders who develop their products entirely on their own, and you can just copy their ideas and adopt it to your market. Let's begin. When Amber was laid off, he got tired of constantly writing cover letters for job applications. To solve this problem, he built a no-code tool that automated the process using ChatGPT and data from LinkedIn. Then he transformed it into a micro MVP and shared it with the market. Over 10,000 people used it in the first month. Now, CoverDoc.ai is a platform that simplifies the job searches process. It allows users to upload their resumes, get information on job openings and companies, create personalized cover letters, prepare for interviews, and access salary data in the market. No code stack. The initial version of the service was built using Airtable, Zapier, OpenAI, and Google Docs. Later, it was expanded with Airtable, automation, landing page tools like Framer and Softr.io, integration with OpenAI via Google Cloud, payments through Stripe, and email campaigns managed with ConvertKit. In January 2024, the subscription price was set at $9.99, and according to the founder, there was no drop in the conversion rate after the price increase. This reinforces a key point I'm always emphasize. If your product delivers real value to users, price become much less a concern. Marketing and distribution efforts included participating in the No-Code Day competition by Zapier, paid email campaigns, and articles on platforms like Geekflare and Zapier. The referral system also proved to be highly effective. By June 2024, CoverDoc had achieved 14K total registration, 10.3% of website visitors signed up for the free plan, 64% of free users converted into paying customers, $1,250 in MRR. So the problem you're currently facing could be very well be the starting point for your own micro SaaS business. Just spend a few weeks launching it, and you might be surprised by what you can accomplish. Next. App Advani, a self-taught engineer who started coding at the age of 6, sold his first startup at 30, and pivoted into SaaS. Despite his programming background, App chose no-code tools to build his products. He shared several insights on no-code. No-code tools speed up feature development often within a day. You can offer more for less. Features are built in days, not months, reducing costs and keeping pricing competitive. It's easy to add custom features for specific clients, making it easier to secure valuable deals. App uses Bubble for fast development and Bubble plugins to extend the functionality. The idea of co-alias came when he wanted to assign a unique domain to each client account, allowing him to increase pricing by 10x. However, Bubble didn't support this feature, so App decided to create his own solution. CoAlias is a multifunctional domain management service. The first version was a quick plugin that he built for his own needs, but later added it to the Bubble plugin marketplace. Over the time, more users started using the plugin and requesting additional features. This was the perfect validation of his idea, which led App to develop a full-fledged service with more useful features and user-friendly interface. App advises focusing on users willing to pay at least $30 per month. These users tend to take their business and scaling efforts more seriously. In contrast, those who wanted to pay under $10 offer churned and required extensive support. As of now, CoAlias has over 1,000 clients, connected more than 60,000 domains. Like and subscribe if you want to learn more about micro SaaS, solo founders, and no-code tools. Next one. The idea of Better Legal emerged when Chad helped a lawyer friend who was losing clients to cheaper online business registration services. Using no-code tools like Asana, Zapier, and Formstack, Chad created a prototype in just 1 week, reducing business registration time from 4 hours to 10 minutes. This allowed his friend to cut prices by 75% and increase profitability. The company started to grow, and at a certain point it became necessary to hire developers to build a web application from scratch. This new scheme helped Better Legal operate in the market for 5 years, but they faced too many issues. Development costs increased with each new feature. Projects often faced delays and took longer than expected. The company was dependent on developers, leaving founders with limited technical understanding. Costs were high, ranging from $8,000 to $10,000 for each new feature and basic tasks. In 2022, facing a difficult solution and potential losses, the company had to cut development expenditures. During this time, Chad found a hope in a 30-day bubble course. Over the next 90 days, he redeveloped Better Legal using Bubble as the primary platform. He also incorporated Productivity Suite for process acceleration, Masonry for low-code components, and integrated with Stripe, Zapier, and Make for automations. Additionally, he used Twilio for communication and Lop for mail services. After transitioning the project back to no-code, their MRR saw a 56% growth for the first time in 6 years, and the number of new users began to grow. This shows that no-code can provide competitive advantages for quick launches and optimizing your software. Fewer employees, reduced cost, flexibility, and a laser focus on one niche audience are the right framework for profitable micro SaaS. Moving to the next one. Jeremy Redman, who used the power of smart cold outreach, no-code tools, and solving his own problem rather than searching for an idea, achieved 30,000 MRR with just 200 users. Task Magic is an automated virtual assistant that simplifies task automation after a single setup. This idea for this service, like many successful projects, came from Jeremy's professional pain. Frustrated with the limitations of Zapier for automating processes, he created a more flexible solution. In the initial phase, Task Magic was almost entirely manual. Jeremy Redman started with a simply tally form where users could input Zapier API endpoints for automation. With this basic product, Jeremy attracted his first customers through cold emails and DMs. He quickly onboarded around 200 users at $199 per month, leading to a 30k MRR. Jeremy offers some crucial advice. Connect with your target audience. Focus on those who truly need your product. Add a personal touch. Jeremy recommended thousands of Loom videos to engage directly with potential customers. Listen to customer problems. Address their issues with your service. Do not be afraid to make changes. Be prepared to adapt and pivot based on users' feedback. In the next phase, as Jeremy added another 100 users, he collected video feedback to enhance functionality. Task Magic evolved into a combination of no-code and custom code. The backend was built using a popular tier, an open-source project, the frontend with Bubble, the marketing side through Webflow, and the database on Airtable. Here are some key success secrets. Identify and address pain points. Jeremy noticed complaints about Zapier high prices and aimed to create an affordable alternative. Focus on improvement. Rather than merely copying Zapier, he took one workflow and significantly enhanced it, outperforming the giant without direct competition. Today, Task Magic boasts nearly 4 million in revenue and over 7,000 paying customers. By the way, if you want to learn more about micro SaaS, no-code tools, AI, and indie hacking, follow me on X, where I share tons of my professional and my clients' insights and host live chats with my community. The next example is all about how you can launch your first micro startup in just 60 hours. And then make an exit within 2 weeks. Fernanda Grazioli, a neuroscientist, decided to create her own project by integrating ChatGPT with Bubble to build a micro startup. She proactively started her development process on Twitter, a popular strategy among new founders known as built in public. The feedback from her Twitter audience was invaluable. So Fernanda got 10 users within 60 hours of work, but unfortunately, she didn't earn any revenue. After receiving a job offer, she started a new job, leaving no time for her app, so she decided to sell the project. Fernanda listed her project on acquire.com, where she received 15 offers in just 2 weeks. The final sale price was $4,000, slightly below her initial asking price of $5,000. This actually reinforces a key rule. When someone is interested in buying your startup, you should act quickly, cry, and sell, even if the price is not exactly what you hoped for. Some valuable tips from Fernanda. Focus on one feature and execute it well, rather than spreading yourself. Engage with people on social media. Discussions, advice, and brainstorming can bring incredible value. Build your product to completion, even if you don't plan to launch it. Ensure everything works smoothly before selling. Even a basic monthly recurring revenue can significantly increase the value and price of your product. Final one. Even receiving $2 million in investments doesn't guarantee that you won't lose everything. Let's talk about Christian and Nate. In 2016, they founded QOins, a service designed to help people save money from daily transactions to pay off credit card and student loan debt. Initially, they developed their MVP on Bubble.io during the evenings while working their regular jobs. Their rapid growth impressed investors, and within a year and a half, they raised their first round of $750,000. This allowed them to expand their product functionality. By 2020, Nate received a $100,000 Google Startups grant, and in 2021, QOins secured an additional $1.5 million in funding. During this period, the service helped over 10,000 clients pay off more than $40 million in debt. However, in June 2023, QOins ceased operation due to issues with bank migration. The former banking partner, Seoul State Bank, refused to transfer customer funds to the new partner, Evolve State and Trust, leading to a lawsuit. With QOins customer support already discontinued by that time, many users were unable to access their funds, which ranged from $300 to $1,000. So, don't put all your eggs in one basket. That's why it's essential to quickly create and launch multiple micro SaaS businesses and build passive income from various sources. That's why you have to use the power of no-code tools, AI, and code. Yes, code. You heard me right. Let me explain. In one of my recent videos, I showed how you can use the power of AI combined with Next.js with literally zero coding knowledge. You just need to learn how to prompt and use a copy-paste method. Anyway, if you want to build a profitable no-code micro SaaS, you need three key components. First, you need to know how to use AI tools to write code for you with simple prompting. Second, you need a Next.js starter kit or a wrapper with pre-built blocks and modules like user authentication, Stripe for payments, database connection, SEO tools, a blog, and an email sending tool. And third, you need your no-code idea, which can be created using tools like Zapier, Relevance AI, or even Code. Whatever you want to integrate into your micro SaaS wrapper. This system allows you to launch and test your ideas in days, not weeks or months. And I have great news for you. I already created a micro SaaS wrapper with all these integrations, link in the description. You just need to create your idea, plug it in, and it's really simple and straightforward. If for any reasons your idea doesn't take off, just repeat the process using your existing infrastructure. A profitable micro SaaS is simply a matter of launching multiple micro startups. Anyone can do it. You can do it. Start shipping your idea today using my tool or build it yourself. The market needs your ideas. See ya!